students, today we are going to do essay paragraph about my country. Okay, the name of my country is Pakistan. It is an Islamic country. Its capital is Islamabad. It has four provinces: Punjab, Sindh, Balochistan, and KPK. It has plains, rivers, mountains, and deserts. It has four seasons: summer, winter, autumn, and spring. It has Arabian Sea in the south. It is beautiful. I love my country. So this is going to be your paragraph. You have to memorize it. Okay. After that, we come to dictation words. Now, 20 words are given to you. Biscuit, picture, smoke, kitten, socks, different, stamp, basin, parcel, whistle, touching, carrying, fight, careless, dangerous, naughty, lorry, swim, wheel, and swing. So these are the words you have to learn them by heart, and you have to memorize these spellings. Okay. After that, we come to masculine and feminine. Now the words are host, hostess, prince, princess, landlord, landlady, nephew, niece, sir, madam, visit, witch, peacock, peahen, groom, bride, boy, girl, and dog, and the word is bitch. Okay, after that, come to page number 11 of your textbook. Now, there is a topic, uncountable nouns. As we see that noun is a verb. Noun, describe you, it is name of verb, place, or thing. Okay? यानी किसी भी चीज़ या जगह का नाम जो होता है वो हम क्या कहलाता है, noun. ठीक है? Now we see that there are two type of noun, countable noun and uncountable noun. Now, countable nouns are those which we can count. For example, when we say pencils, now we say 10 pencils, 2 pencils, 3 razors, 5 chairs, 6 desks. So, these are countable nouns which we can count. And another type is uncountable noun. Now, uncountables are those nouns which we cannot count. For example, this is piece of chalk. Okay, now piece. We can't count peas. The word wood. This is a piece of soap. Okay. This is a piece of string. This is a piece of paper. Now these are all things which we cannot count. So these are called uncountable noun. This is a glass of water. This is bottle of milk. Now here we see that these are verbs. Chalk, wood, soap, string, paper, water, milk, soap, ink. So these are verbs, but these are uncountable. Now what you have to do is you have to write these sentences on your notebooks and you have to underline the uncountable nouns. Okay. Now related to this, we have exercise practice questions and answer like this. Look at number one. What is it? It is a glass of milk. Look at number two. What is it? It is a piece of string. Now, all are uncountable nouns and you have to write them in question answers form. Now, similarly, look at number three. What is it? It is ink. ठीक है? After that, we come to unit number 2 and this is, can she sing? Yes, she can. Now we are going to use can in these sentences. Can he sing? उर्दू में हम क्या कहेंगे? क्या वो गा सकती है? क्या वो गा सकता है? No, he cannot. नहीं, वो नहीं कर सकता. Okay. Similarly, if the question would be, can he hear? No, she cannot. Again, can he see? No, he cannot. Can he see? Yes, he can. Can she speak? No, she cannot. Now this exercise is on page number 13 of your textbook. Can Jameel swim? Yes, he can. Can Sara Khan cook? No, she can't. Can Mr. Beg drive a bus? Yes, he can. Can Usma ride a bicycle? No, she cannot. Can the men carry the box? Yes, they can. Can you see the bird in the tree? Yes, I can. Can you see the man in the sea? Yes, I can. Okay, so you have to practice these. Now what you have to do is, you have to write sentences on page number 13 on your textbook. Okay, like you have to write, can he sing? And similarly, you have to give the answer, no, he cannot. After that, we come to unit 3, and this is like. Okay, now we are going to learn the use of like. I like apples, I like oranges, I like bananas, I like sweets. They like cakes, they like ice cream. Okay, like mean pasand karna. I like apples, kyunki main apple pasand karti hu. I like oranges, मैं orange पसंद करती हूँ. इस तरह आप अपनी कोई भी चीज़ बता सकते हैं, ठीक है. आप अगर अपनी feeling को express करना चाहें, किसी चीज़ का बताना चाहें, so you can word use the word like, and you can say I like chocolates, I like sweets, I like rice. Similarly, you can use different verb. Like you can use this word to describe your activity. For example, I like this ball. Thank you. He likes the ball. Okay. Similarly, now we can see that we use I like this doll. Thank you. She likes the doll. I like the yellow flower. Thank you. She likes the yellow flower. Now she is telling about her choice, about her likes, and they are saying that she likes. Okay. I like the red frog. Thank you. He likes the red frog. Now what you have to do is, revision exercise is, make 6 good sentences. Please give me a piece of paper. Okay, so you have to complete this column. Now exercise B is, answer the question, can a fish swim? Yes, it can. Can a dog fly? No, it can't. Can a dog swim? Can a cat swim? Can you swim? So similarly, you have to answer this according to the exercise we have done. Make 5 sentences beginning I like. Similarly, as I have told you, that you can write any sentence, like I write reading, I like watching cartoons, I like swimming, I like playing. So you can form your own sentences, and you have to do this work on your notebook. After that, we have make 3 sentences beginning my friend likes. Like you can say, my friend likes reading storybook, my friend likes playing football, my friend plays with the doll. So you can make your own sentences. Okay, now we come to unit 4. Now we are going to use comparison, and for comparison we use the word but. Nasir is tall but Uzma is short. Okay, now you can see the opposite words also, and you can see the comparison. For example, Nasir is tall but Uzma is short. Okay, now tall is and short are the opposite word. This book is thick but this book is thin. This writing is bad but this writing is good. So you can again use the word, use of but, and you can also see the opposite word used over there. This blackboard is black but this chalk is white. Usma can swim but she cannot ride a bicycle. Sara Khan can sing but she cannot cook. The men can carry the box but they cannot carry the tree. Mr. Beg can drive a bus but he cannot fly an aeroplane. Read, this dash is circle but this is not a circle, it is a square. This is a bell but this is not a bell, it's a drum. Okay, again you are going to use this and you have to write first four sentences on your notebook. Read aloud. Now we are going to use, these are called vowel sounds, when we can A, E, I, O, U. Now these are all vowel sounds. Now you can see the use over there. Like in the apple, it is used in the start. In the word bag, it is used in the middle. Similarly, this word is also used in the word black, cat, pen. Okay, now we come to unit 5. It is on page number 22 of your textbook, and this is the word that and those. As we have seen that the word that we use for the things that are not near to us, okay, and the plural of that is those when we have so many things. For example, this is a pen and that is a pencil. Okay, now I can see that this is a board marker and that is the pencil or pen. Now I am holding this, therefore I am using the word this, and the other thing is not near to me, it is not nearer to me, so I am going to use the word that. This is the bag and this is the box. Now she is holding the bags, therefore she is saying that this is a bag and that. Okay, she is referring to the thing. This is a book and that is the picture. For example, I can say that this is a marker and this and that is a board. Okay, this is a board marker and that is a board. This is a bird and that is an aeroplane. Now again he is holding a bird in his hand and he is saying this is a bird and that is an aeroplane. Now when we are going to talk about plural objects, we are going to use plural of that and it is called those. These are glasses and those are bottles. These are apples and those are apples. These are stockings and those are socks. These are cats and those are dogs. These are girls and those are boys. Now we are going to use the use of that and those. I hope you will be able to understand the concept. This window is open, but that window is shut. This bag is small, but that bag is big. This car is old, but that car is new. These apples are red, but those apples are green. These bottles are empty, but those bottles are full. So what you have to do is you have to write first three sentences from page number 22 on your notebook, and then you have to write again first three sentences of page number 23 on your notebook, and you will be able to understand the concept of word that and those. Thank you.